A sickness, oh God, or a circumstance why they could not come today, God. But we lifting them up to you right now in the mighty name of Jesus. And oh God, we ask, oh God, that you heal, set free, and deliver right now in the name of Jesus. We come against depression right now in the name of Jesus. We come against lack right now in the name of Jesus. Someone might have cancer this morning, God. But we come against it right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, we plead the blood of Jesus over that person right now in the name of Jesus. We claim healing. Someone might have a problem with their mind, God. Do it for us right now, God. Everyone that's in our inner circle, God, we thank you right now in the name of Jesus. And Lord, we let us not forget our pastor, God, and our first lady, God, that you stationed here at Elm Grove Missionary Baptist Church. The man and the woman of God that stands on the wall and cries out for your people right now in the name of Jesus. Lord, we ask that you bless them 100-fold in the name of Jesus. Anoint them, oh God, so they might continue to do the work that you have set before them in the name of Jesus. Some days might not be good, but God, we know that you will give them supernatural strength to do what they need to do for you and for your people in the name of Jesus. We ask that you bless the deacons, oh God, the deaconesses. Our mothers, oh God, that's at home praying for us, God. The praise team, our musicians, oh God. Even the ushers that stand at the door, God. We thank you, God, right now in the name of Jesus. Our ministers, oh God. Everyone that's a minister of the gospel, God. We thank you for them right now in the name of Jesus. And everyone that's in the pews this morning, God. We ask that you touch right now in the name of Jesus. God, we ask that you go from person to person, from man to woman, from boy to girl, and touch right now in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost, we invite you in. We invite you in to have your way in the name of Jesus. We ask all these things in your name, Jesus. Amen, amen, and amen.
Our scripture reading this morning comes from Psalms 46, amen. Psalms 46, not for sure where I want to stop. The whole text is good. Amen. Psalms 46, beginning at verse 1, where it says, God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, will not we fear, though the earth be removed, and though the mountain be carried in the midst of the sea, though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof, Selah. There is a river, the streams whereof shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacles of the Most High. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God shall help her, and that right early. The heathen raged. The kingdoms were moved. He uttered his voice. The earth melted. The Lord of hosts is with us. Gotta do verse 7 again. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Selah. Come, behold the works of the Lord. What desolations he hath made in the earth. He make wars to cease unto the end of the earth. He breaketh the bow and cutteth the spear in sunder. He burneth the chariot in fire. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the heathen. I will be exalted in the earth. Here it is. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Selah. Amen. We read Psalms 46 in its entirety. God bless the hearers, the readers, and doers of his word.
Amen. Amen. Father God, it's in the name of Jesus. Oh, Lord, we stand in your presence and we want to say thank you. Lord, we thank you for the presence of the Holy Ghost, God. We thank you for his presence enabling us to feel your power and your might. Lord, we thank you for this offering that we have received in your name. We ask that you continue to bless us, that we are able to be a blessing to the kingdom. These and all the blessings we ask in Jesus' name. And the people of God say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Right now, we're going to be praying with the selection from our praise team. Let's give them a hand.
Come on and bless the Lord in me. Come on and bless the Lord. Yeah.
7 p.m. we'll have live stream. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. On second Sunday, which is next Sunday, beginning at 10 a.m., we have our church school. And 11 a.m. will be Mother's Day service.
Yeah.
The world. Amen. All of the mothers. Amen. And on third Sunday at 10 a.m., we will have our church school again. Always 10 a.m. on Sunday morning. And Sunday at 11 a.m., we will be celebrating our Women's Day service. Amen. Our speaker will be Copperless Victoria Blue. Our assessments is $50 for adult, $25 for young adults, and $10 for our youth. Renee Ryan University. Lenore. I'm Gullah Geechee. Class of 2023 graduate, Jimmy Lee Palmer III.
Celebrate birthdays and anniversaries of the month of May. First on the list is our pastor, Pastor
birthday. Amen.
Happy birthday.
Jesus promised you'll take care of me.
Thank you, Lord. Amen. I got that one in my spirit. Jesus promised that he'll take care of me. Amen. And the word of God tells me that God is not a man that he should lie. Neither is he the son of man that he should repent. If he said, he's going to make it good. Amen. And I believe that in my spirit. Amen. And I'm a living witness that the Lord will take care of me. Amen. It gives me great honor as well as a privilege to introduce our speaker for the hour, none other than our bishop, our pastor, the Reverend Dr. Jerald J. Thomas. Amen. Amen. To those of you that don't know Pastor Thomas, amen, he's a man of God. Amen. There's a scripture in the Bible that when the chief captain of the army servant was sick, and he was wondering to himself, and there was this handmaiden that was captive that was brought, and she said, I know a man that got an excellent spirit, Sister Jenkins, Reverend Jenkins. Pastor Thomas got an excellent spirit. Amen. It's the spirit of the living God. Amen. And that time, amen, the power of God only rested on a few. Amen. But our Sunday school lesson taught us this morning that the power of God will rest on all of us. Amen. From generation to generation, the Holy Ghost is yours for the asking. And the question was asked, have you received the Holy Ghost since you believe? Amen. So we pray, God, that if you haven't received it, that when you leave this place today, you can say, I receive the Holy Ghost since I believe. With all that said, amen, as I said before, it gives me great honor to introduce a true man of God, the bishop of our soul. Amen. A real man of God that preaches and teaches the story. Amen. Amen. Preach and teach the cross. Amen. That's what we need, the cross. Amen. So but after the choir has sung, I ask that you would stand in reverence to the word that the man of God has carried. And that you ask God to prepare your heart through the unction of the Holy Ghost, that you would get it in your spirit. Amen. And that's all I'm going to ask. That if you get it in your spirit, and you got the right spirit within you, we don't have to worry. You can stand on the promises of God. After the choir is sung, the next voice you will hear is none other than that, than Pastor Thomas. Pastor Thomas to the congregation. Congregation, Pastor Thomas. Amen. Amen. Let's say yes, thank God for Pastor Thomas. Amen.
Forever, oh my soul will sing. You Hallelujah. The highest praise a believer can give to the Almighty God. Hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord, we praise you. We give you glory. And we give you the honor. Let us now go before God's rich throne of grace. Abba, Father, it is in the matchless name of Jesus we humbly now come before thy rich throne of grace. Master, we come with thanksgiving. We say thank you for how you brought us. We say thank you for how you're keeping us. And we say thank you for our eyes have not seen, neither have our ears heard what you have prepared for us. Now, Lord, allow preaching and teaching to become easy. Touch the hearts of your men and women, boys and girls. And we invite you, Holy Spirit, to just come in and tabernacle. Breathe afresh. Somebody needs a healing in here. Somebody needs deliverance. Somebody needs to be comforted in their spirit. Somebody just needs a precious walk with you. Touch. Allow the words of my mouth and the meditations of mine heart to be acceptable in thine sight. O Lord, my strength and my redeemer, for it is all in the matchless name of Jesus that we pray, and everybody said amen, 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 and amen. Come on, let's celebrate it on the first Sunday of the month of May. 5 months into the new year, 23. Come on and let's give God some glory. Had not the Lord been on our side, where would we be? Come on, you can just tell him thank you. Put your hand clap. You out in cyberland, just tell him thank you. In your living rooms, in your bedrooms, wherever you might be, just tell him thank you. Hallelujah. Glory to his name. Hallelujah. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. And we do honor the Lord in the spirit of holiness and the triuneness of God. Our Father, amen, his Son Jesus, who is our Savior and Redeemer and our Keeper and Guide, the precious Holy Ghost. Amen. We want to acknowledge everyone in their respective places. And I want to especially thank the praise team and the drum. Amen. They're doing a wonderful job. I know we, amen. We're global there. And we're bold enough to stand before God. Amen. In his presence. And even sing without the tender strums of a string of the guitar or the key of the piano. But one thing I know, God is a rhythm worker in me. In me? Do you know him? Do you know him? I wonder, do anybody in here know him? In the pardon of your sin, I ain't talking about knowing by name. I'm talking about. Hallelujah. So to everyone in their respective places, amen, to our Facebook and YouTube subscribers and viewers, we thank God for your presence. Amen. You, many of you have been very faithful with the church and for the church, and we just want to take this opportunity to thank you, you and you, and you're in cyberland. Amen. We thank God. Well, in my time with the Lord and studying and preparing for today, I asked the Lord, I said, Lord, what just can we talk about? Amen. And you know how you be turning pages in the Bible? You who read the Bible. Amen. When you go to turning pages or on your notebook or your tablet, am I right? Amen. You go to looking at things and bam! And God got a word for you. It hits like a hammer striking metal. And fire sparks begin to break off of you. Amen. And then it's confirmed by another witness or another witness. So if you have your sword with you today, I want to ask you, if you would, to turn with me. Amen. Because we're going to do a lot of teaching today. Some of us need some teaching too, including me. Amen. We're going to be looking at the old eagle-eyed prophet, the prophet Isaiah. Amen. And the word of God shall be drawn from the 40th chapter of the book of Isaiah. And know this, amen, that Isaiah is a prophet, a major prophet in the Old Testament. Our theme scripture from the 40th chapter and verse number 28 is going to read like this. Has thou not known? A question is being asked. Has thou not known? Has thou not heard? Anybody told you about this? Listen at it now. That the everlasting God, and the word everlasting is very important. Everlasting to some of us might mean one thing, and everlasting to others might mean another thing, but everlasting is just what it said. Forever lasting. Even in eternity, it is there. It says, the Lord. Now, the word of God is being specific here. The Lord. Now, if he's been revealed to you as the creator, how many of you know him as the creator of the heavens and the earth? How many of you know that it was he who created man in his image and in his likeness? If you can believe that God created you and you did not evolve from a monkey, then you know him as the creator. Some of us think we came from monkeys and apes, but I come to bust your bubble. You ain't that pretty. The creator, amen, of the ends of the earth. He controls the entire earth. Huh? He what? Fainted not. In other words, he don't quit. God doesn't have to quit when you know God. He fainted not, neither is he weary. You don't get tired. There is no searching. You can't understand who God is with that pea brain we have. With the finite being that we are, we will never comprehend who and what God. Oh, you will get to know him, but you will never be able to fathom who God is. How many of you been trying to find out who God is? Has anybody in here been really searching to just to get to know? You're wasting your time this morning, because that ought to be a top priority with all of us Christian believers, to get to know him even better. Have you not heard? Do you not know who he is? You know, many of us been trying to figure this thing out. Huh? We've been searching in our mind. Why? Most of our questions about God is why. That lets you know right there, you don't understand him when you ask why. Now, you can ask God why and how all you want to. And this first lady told me he ain't got to answer you. You can ask him, like I said, like, why do you say I can't question God? You can question all you want to. But will you receive an answer? Oh my God. So here it is now. We as a body of believers, what I'm noticing in as a pastor of Christian believers is that through the last 4 years, and I hate to keep putting this on the pandemic, but it was such a large thing that happened globally that it took most of our minds our hearts away from God. You might not want to hear this, and you may not want to say it then, but even the best of us lost connection with God. Oh, you know his name, and God ain't his name. That's his title. God. That's what you say when you don't know nothing else to say. But can you say Jehovah Jireh? Can you say Adonai? Do, would you know what you're saying when you call him El Elyon? Would you know? See, you got to have an intimate relationship just like me. You can't call me Jerald. I can take it a little further. You can't call me Butch. You don't know me like that. Am I right about it? A lot of us, that's why we stop with saying God. God. When you gonna say Yahweh? Because there's a time that Yahweh fits what you're going to be talking about. Huh? And the Nah fits what you're going to be talking about. The El Elyon gonna fit what you're talking about when you're addressing God. When you want to get certain places with God, you got to use some of the attributes of God and the characteristics of God to talk to him. Well, I know when a man come to me, amen, and we're gonna, he gonna talk about, you know, sliding and amen. I said, yeah, you one of the brothers, the old mothers. You one of those brothers from the old mothers back in the day. And we can talk. Am I right about it? It is certain things that get your attention. And so it is with God. A lot of us have forgotten how to come draw nigh to God. Yeah. We think we can sit home and watch the, look at the radio and the live stream and all of that. Amen. But God was strictly trying to tell us, I love you so much that I gave my only begotten son for your life, and you drifted away from me like a ship, amen, lost its tether, its anchor. You're floating, just floating around. God said it is time, church, to come back to God. God is calling us, and he's calling us, but many of us are so successful now and think we so blessed that we don't need God till we get in a mess. But I come to tell you, every day of your life you need to be calling on the Lord. Not when you just sit, not when things are not going well, not when you've been lied on and talked about and pushed to the curb, but you talk to God because you love him. I love my wife. I wake up in the morning, I'm feeling for her. Sometimes she done got out of bed to go pray. But I ain't gonna lay there and wait for her to come back. I'm gonna tip. See if she's really praying outdoors somewhere. Ain't no mistrust or not trust, but I'm just curious of where she at. How many of you curious about God in your life? Well, I come to tell you, he's omnipresent. If you have confessed Jesus as your Lord and Savior, amen, and you believe that he delivered you from all of that mess, you can call on him in the midnight hour. You can call on him in the noonday. You can call on him late in the nighttime, but God will show up for you. He shows up. He says, I've been calling on God and I ain't heard nothing yet. You haven't been listening. He speaks. I speak verbally all the time. Sometimes he speaks when the wind blows. He letting you know, I'm God. I'm in charge. If you would, amen, let's look at the 22nd verse, amen, in the same chapter, chapter 40. Are you with me? Now look what Isaiah is saying here. He says, it is he, talking about God, it is he that sitteth upon the circle of the earth. God. Awesome God. A God worthy to be praised. What did you draw from that nugget, Thomas? I drew from that nugget that the earth is round if he's sitting in a circle.
Come on. Come on. Amen.
It's not
not flat like some of us thought, that if you go to the edge, you might fall off. The earth is round. He's telling you, he sits upon the circle. Now, if he sits upon the circle of the earth, do you know how vast the earth is? But God owns the entire universe. And a lot of us won't even tell him hallelujah. I listen to the people saying hallelujah in here. If God would have walked through those double doors right now, some of you wouldn't know who he would be. But I guarantee you, you'll feel his presence. You will know his presence, because his presence indwells on the inside. And when it hits and it recognizes. I can tell when you got hell in you in church, because the Spirit of God already alert me and tell me she got hell in her. He got hell in her. He mad by something. She upset by something. She think, I don't know what's set behind the secret desk. You must be a see when God got you. Tell your neighbor, God know what you got in your body. If you're sick in your body, God know. God want to heal you. God want to deliver you. But you got to taste and see that he's good and believe that he would. A lot of us say we want it, but we don't want it, because we don't want it by faith. Somebody to give it to us. We want somebody to call it for us. But you gotta snatch your healing. You gotta snatch your blessing. You gotta snatch your. Sometimes you gotta get violent and take back by force what the enemy has stolen from you. He told you he was out to kill, to steal, and to store. Has he stolen anything from you lately? I can't see your face because you got masks on, but I guarantee you he done took your smile from you. He done took your joy from you. He's taking your peace from you. Most of y'all scared to get up and just say hallelujah. Glory to God. I'm leaving this. You out of practice. A lot of us don't know what to say. When you hear the word, if you agree with it, you say what? Amen. I ain't hear no amen. Sky say amen. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. How many of you understand? I bless you and receive it, daughter, in the name of Jesus the Christ. Since the beginning of time, human beings, people, us, we've been trying to unsuccessfully comprehend the fullness of God's nature. We've been trying. We've been looking. But we use it. And our minds are fallen. When we came into this earth, you came here, unsaved. You didn't come here saved and righteous. You came here a wretch undone. But God had a way out for you. Many of us didn't accept it. That's why he's asking the question. Look at here in the 28th verse. Hast thou not known? Did anybody ever tell you about the saving power of Jesus Christ? Did anybody just sit down and talk to you about how God created the heavens and the earth? Did anybody ever talk to you about, I receive it, daughter, about how God touched the heavens, amen, and brooded over the darkness, and the Holy Ghost was right there with him? Before anything ever was, God was. I don't care what position we get, what authority we have, we don't have all power. We only got a smidgen. And that's in these places. Look what he states here now. Amen. As we go a little further, many of you understand? Let's say, thus it has been said that God created man, Brother Andy, in his image and in his likeness. And then you know what happened, Deacon Bubba? Man created gods in his image and in his likeness. He made his gods look like him. You ever been to Egypt? You ever been to Ethiopia? You ever been to any of those other places over there? Amen. They made their gods to look physically like them. They got it twisted, BB. Because he said in his image and in his likeness, he wasn't talking physically. He said, I made you a three-part being, body, soul, and spirit. I made you in like the triuneness of who I am. But you don't look like me. You don't talk like me. You don't breathe like me. You're worshiping your kind of God. Many of us done made gods out of our houses, out of our cars, out of our children. Y'all ain't talking to me here. Out of our education level. We have made gods out of other things, things that we love and enjoy. Our first God is money. We love it. We'll sacrifice our lives for a dollar bill. People have left God, walked away from God because they can make more money doing what they want to do in the secular than can with God. And we talk about we holy. We got to go back now, brothers and sisters, and examine ourselves. Who's first in your life? God says, I am a jealous God. Thou shalt have no other gods, little G's, before me. I am the Alpha and the Omega. I'm your beginning and I'm your end. God trying to talk to you. God trying to tell you, look at here, when you get in trouble, before you get in trouble, look to me. While you're living, when the first thing when you wake up in the morning, look to me. All through the daytime, talk to me. You ain't got to bend down on your knees or lay in the bed in a certain posture. You can walk and talk to me. And if you can't talk, grow. Sometimes you look up there. Sometimes you just got to groan it out. Why? Because the devil can't understand what you're talking about here. Amen. But God said he pitied every groan. Didn't he say it in his word? He pitied every groan. Every now and then you just got to talk to him in another language. Sometimes you got to talk to him in an unknown tongue. Sometimes you just got to get all by yourself with God and say, here I am, Father. I know you're the top of the line. I'm going to close here now. Oh, God. Mankind is something else. As I close 28th verse, amen, 29th verse, look what it does when you hang in there. Dang, this ain't nothing, Pastor, making up. Good to see you, Reverend Brooks, not Van. 29th verse. He giveth power to the faith. If you hang in there. How many of you sometimes feel like you're through? You just feel like, I'm done. I'm finished with it. On life's journey sometimes, you know the trials and the wares of the world can beat us
down to the ground. But look what he states here. He said, he giveth power to the faint. And to them that have no might, tell your neighbor, he increaseth strength. You know how he does that? Brother Robert Jr., you come to him in prayer. But before you get down to prayer, amen, it's a praise time in there. And it's a worship time. I found out that when I began to praise God, amen, that heaven began to open up. And even in my weakness and in my being tired of everything, God began to pour his spirit upon his vessel. And I found out that even though I was worn down, weary, and sad, I had to remember that God can and will make me glad. You see, when I was about to turn around and hold up my hands and say I surrender, God began to give me strength where I could walk through the valleys and the shadow of death. Amen. And I felt so all alone sometimes. I felt like a motherless child. But one thing, as I look back, God told me, he said, even young folk, amen, even though they are physically strong, even though they stay in the workout centers all the time, even though they have vitamins and supplements that they are taking, he said, the youth shall faint and be weary. Physically, they're going to get tired. And sometimes the church going to get a little tired. Sometimes they get a little weary, a little broken down. And they shall utterly fall. But when you are with the Lord, look what he says. He told me to tell you. He said, but they that wait upon the Lord. I ain't talking about serving. I ain't talking about being a waiter. I'm talking about while you're supposedly waiting on God, that God will continue to walk with you. As you wait on him, he'll build your strength. As you wait on him, he'll give you courage. As you wait on him, he'll open up doors. As you wait on him, he'll make your enemy your footstool. And as you wait on him, God makes a way out of no way. When you were down and out, didn't have a friend or nobody to talk to, you waited on the Lord, and the Lord came to your rescue. How many times I had to tell you, he sits high and looks low. Got all power in his hand. He controls the moon and the stars. He tells the sun when to rise. And he also tells him when to set. God got all power. He can tell you the name of all the stars in the universe. That's how omniscient the God that we serve. He can take the universe and spread a cover over the entire universe and tell you, I can make tents for my people.
Because God is saying, when I look down from my seat, you look like grasshoppers. You look like little kicks in the earth. I come to tell you, I govern, said the Lord, the heavens and the earth. I got all power in my hand. I decide whether you live or whether you die. I decide whether you got power or no power. I decide to be your God, and I love you anyhow. I'ma be with you down to the year. I brought you up, now I have you where you need to be. Come on back home to me. I'm your loving father. I am a boss. I'm your daddy. I made you, did not do it, and then when you couldn't understand me, I told my son, I'ma wrap him up in flesh, looking like a natural man. I'ma send you down to the earth to seek and to save all of them who are lost. They don't understand that I am the God of their salvation. I make it rain when I want it to rain. I make crops grow when I want crops to grow. I got a rotation in the earth that send the moon in the cycles. Half moon, quarter moon, full moon. I got the power to change everything. And you sitting around here saying there's no God, I come to tell you, you a fool, because a fool said it. There is no Holy Ghost. There is no Savior. There is no God. Come on, and go with me. Look what he said. I shall renew. Tell your neighbor, God that put muscle on the hustle. I'm getting stronger every day. When I go through battles, it's like a workout. I'm working out, getting the legs in shape. Heartaches, get the heart in shape. My back been carrying a heavy load. All he's doing is getting me in position. Tell your neighbor, he must have me on a workout. He been trying, he tried, didn't he try? He tried me, but one thing for sure, my strength has been renewed. I'm mounting up. Tell your neighbor, mount up, mount up, mount up. In other words, get up, take off, take a flight for the Lord, and watch him let you soar, soar higher, 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 higher. More pretty than me and way more than we praise God. The accolades are good for Pastor Lane. You don't need it now. I thank Brother Sam for lifting me up. But let me tell you all something. Lift God. In our churches, we talk about everything but God. We talk about what people ain't doing, how they didn't do this, how they should have done that, that one they did that. You need to be praising God. Get that joke out your throat. salvation. Have you not heard? Jesus is coming soon. Do you not know that those who die in the Lord will get up? But if you die a sinner, you're going to get up a sinner. You're going to hell. You're going to confess Jesus Christ and live for him. Hell will be your home. We brag, oh, we've been here. We've been there. But when the last time you've been with the Lord? We don't use this word to argue and fuss and fit and prove. It speaks for itself. And what has happened to many of us are with our own derivations of the word and what we think it is. I messed up a lot of people in church. But it's deeper than what we first knew. Reflect back. Your culture taught you how to serve.
Come on.
Am I right?
Amen.
We do what us always have to do. But what about what God is saying?
Yes, so.
The old ones weren't all right, neither were they all wrong.
That's right.
And we did it the best we could to get to where we are now.
Amen.
But brothers and sisters, we are in the end time. And you can find out this. Skin color? Don't matter. When you cut, when you go into surgical, they spit you down, and you can have another nationality in there, no matter how you look the same. That's what the doctor was telling. He said, see, we let the enemy use the great weapon against us. The first child that was killed, the first murder, was all because of jealousy and envy. And that's what got us messed up in the churches today, in our homes today, in our person. It's jealousy and envy and doubt and judging one another. Remember, with the same judgment, always say, you got three and a thumb, and that thumb carry big weight. And all of them coming right back at you. You're going to be yours too. Brothers and sisters, Jesus died for your sins and mine. And I accepted him and the redemptive work that he wrote for me. I make it personal. You know something? A lot of us trying to preach and don't even know who God is.
Come on.
A lot of us trying to teach. Oh, God. Do you have an intimate relationship with him? Intimate means, I ain't talking about physical.
No.
I'm talking about close. We are into one another. I'm in her and she in me. I'm sorry. When you get with God, he gets in you.
That's right.
And you in him. Y'all so close, can't tear y'all apart.
That's right.
The picture that First Lady and I try to show you all that. This is how the church is supposed to be.
That's right.
Just like this.
Right.
Husband and wife.
That's right.
Walking together. Pastor and church. Not, go ahead, church.
Oh.
Not church. And pastor all. You understand me? You never see the picture. How many of you see the picture? We are his bride. He's preparing to come and receive us unto himself. And he has charged me. I'm sorry, Ava. He has charged me as a man of God. This is a mandate upon my life. Bring them back to me. They run around getting information from heaven. They don't know what they're getting. People are playing to your ego, your mindset, and tell you how great you are. But they way of deceiving you. Just like a good marriage. Folk don't like to see a good marriage. A good example. They find all kind of dirt and dig it up on you. Bring it up. Put it where it can be exposed. We got to wake up, brothers and sisters, and live for God. How many of you going to live for the Lord? I mean, live for God. I guarantee you, if you put him first today and began to learn of him, watch how he began to direct your path. He's going to heal it. Spend time in that word and let it play over you at night. He's going to heal it. He's going to heal it. He's going to heal it. Let's give my little daughter a hand. See me? I just want them to know that this is your last week as a single woman. Tell the boys you're off the market. Ain't no more here. Bless the Lord. How's everybody feeling in here? How you doing, Lord? You doing all right, son? Good to see you, man. How you doing, young man?
Thank you,
Lord. All right. Good to see you. You hanging with...
He works for me. Take care of me.
I tell you what, you got a great marriage, son. And he gonna take good care of you. He got you in the right place today. No matter. What's your name? Chance?
Yeah, I know
it's a
van too.
Van? Not van. I'm just teasing. Hey, Van is a great man. Yeah, he is. Hold his hand, James. Brother James, just put your hand on. Father, in the name of Jesus, now bless Chance with the blessing that he stands in need of. Cover him and keep him in Jesus' name. If there's anyone here today out of the ark of safety, I want to give you an opportunity to give your life to Jesus Christ. You can come by letter, come Christian Experience, a candidate for baptism or restoration. I'm saying, you know, say that. You say, well, which way? Now? Come on, sister, say, well, hey, let me hear your voice. Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. You're out of the ark of safety. No matter where you are, God's voice can reach you. God's hand is reaching out for you right now. It says, come. Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I'll give you rest. I'll give you rest from your trials. Rest from tribulations. I'll give you rest. And I'll make heaven your home for eternity. Come to me. Come. Letter, Christian Experience, candidate for baptism or restoration. Anyone desire a word of prayer, you may come, or you may stand at your seat, however you desire. Only trust him. Only trust him.
Amen. We know that the enemy try to destroy a family because he knows there's power in the family. So that's why the Holy Spirit wise pastor was preaching. We say family. Even if your husband is not here and you here, we ask that you come to the altar. Amen. Because if he can destroy the marriage, then the church. So that's why the Holy Spirit said, pray for marriage couple, for those that are engaged or whatever. Amen. Because I'm a married woman, even though I'm married to a pastor. Sometimes it can get rough because we're two different persons with two different personalities. But then we must come together and reason together for the well-being of the household. And that's why we know it's a struggle sometimes being married. Not saying we got problems or anything, but sometimes. And I'm being real and I'm saying that I love the Lord, but it can be a struggle sometimes. Sometimes I have to go and start speaking in tongues and say, Lord, hold, come on, Lord. Amen. So we ask, Pastor, we're going to anoint everything.
Thank you, Lord. We are humble and grateful. You know, through your steadfastness, you're still being faithful. And that's the awesome thing about knowing God and knowing him in the pardon of your sins. If you don't know him like you feel like you ought to, get to know him. Teenagers, y'all get to know God and leave all that foolishness alone out there. Good to see you, Zakiya. Hallelujah. You got another daughter, I guess. Have a grand
daughter. Thank you, Lord God. Right now, in the name of Jesus.
You got them all, baby? Okay. Okay, let us pray. If you're standing together and you got your mate, you can squeeze the hand just to let them know you're living. I'm alive and I'm well. And if you, I want you to hear me, man. Man, look at your wife in the eyes. Look at them. Just look at them. Look at them in their eyes. Their eyes tell a story. Their eyes tell a story. Now, as you look them in the eyes, tell them, I love you. I love you. I love you. Amen. Amen. Father, Abba. Now, Lord, many of these of your people, I know that we all have issues or things in life as a couple, as a marriage, that we are confronted with. But we know through your word that as we were married under your word and your pledge and the vow that we made, we ask that you strengthen us now. Oh God, I pray that you will build up the interference that will keep Satan away out of our marriages and our unions. And give us strength. We apply the blood of the crucified Savior to allow peace and joy and happiness and prosperity. And Lord, give us long life and good health. God, let us love one another as we've never loved before. And God, let us respect and honor one another, for that all comes with love. And God, we thank you for all things. And we know, God, that your grace is sufficient. And we come to you now thanking you for your grace and your mercy that have allowed us to be together for this long. And God, we give you the glory, the honor, and the praise as you continue to order our steps and direct our path. Oh God, cover us and keep us under the blood and let us prosper and be in good health, even as our souls prosper. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
All right, I'm going to be fair. All the marriage people go by. We want the singles. All the singles, come on. Amen. Even the young girls, amen. Amen. Being led by the Spirit. Sometimes we can have a program. Amen. Come quickly, while the Holy Ghost is, come on, come on, come on. Amen. Amen. Reverend Jenkins, I want you to all the disciples. single ladies and the young ladies. Come on. Do it quickly. Do it quickly. Amen.
Oh, Father. Oh, Father. We thank you for these young ladies. Amen. We thank you, Lord, for them and their obedience. We thank you, Lord. Many of them, they've been under your word for quite a while. And I just pray your divine strength upon them all in their respective places. Father, in the name of Jesus, we now present these daughters before you. And they stand before your altar. We all have various needs. And you even told us in your word that you would even give us the desires of our hearts if we delight ourselves in you. And I pray, God, that you put a spirit of delight in these young ladies. Perfectional, God. And God, give them good health. Help them to prosper. And give them long life. If they don't have the person that they want in their life, God, you'll send it when time. Let them wait patiently upon you, God. But as they wait, let them serve you. Let them praise you and let them worship you. And God, you do the rest, God. You will bless them beyond their greatest expectation. And that one thing that they've been crying out to you about, God, today was the reason why First Lady had them to come to this altar. Because you and you alone are going to meet them at their points of need. Bless them now supernaturally, God. This is your miracle working season. This is your time of healing, deliverance, and prosperity. Cover and keep them now. All in Jesus' name we pray. And everybody said amen. 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 Why are you standing there? Everybody that can stand. Amen. You got your phone? Take a selfie. Amen. You can do it right in here. Get yourself in there. Go on and do it. Now unto him again, who's able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before his throne of majesty, power, and dominion, to the only true and wise God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. And everybody said amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And amen. God bless you. Heaven smile.